10th week after his Christmas break, Andrew Green, BA, MSc, of the Department for Work and Pensions, switched off his alarm and kissed his wife on the cheek. He did so without waking her, because she had the morning off.
Andrew slipped into his dressing gown, because it was getting frosty in the mornings. But Andrew did not put on his slippers, both because he'd read in The Guardian that bacterial exposure from carpet was good for the immune system, and because they didn't match his pyjama bottoms, which unsettled him deeply.
Andrew walked downstairs, taking care to do so slowly so as to warm up, as he didn't want to tear anything. The floor creaked, and for a second or two, Andrew was concerned that the noise was coming from his knee. But it wasn't. In the kitchen, breakfast was.
What? A banana, fruit essential. Enough sugars for immediate energy, with vitamin C as well as blueberries.
Two tea. Enough caffeine to warm him up, but not enough to throw up his gut pH or make him jittery like a coffee. Caffeine in moderated quantities can be integrated into a balanced diet.
Three, rye bread cut into soldiers. Fruit has lots of easily processed sugars, so Andrew thought it best taking carbs in more gradually processed form after banana. Rye bread is low GI and lacks gluten, a potential bowel irritant.
Four, a boiled egg. Andrew told his friends that the boiled egg was fast digesting protein, although he knew, strictly speaking, that the science on dippy eggs was unconvincing at best. He found the egg pleasing in its little cup. He made less of a mess than when he scrambled or fried it. And he was pleasantly reminded of his childhood.
The overall portion size was small, because well research indicated that smaller portion sizes were correlated with greater life expectancy. And although causation was not assured, Andrew felt like playing it safe. Finally, he left the kitchen to take a massive shit. He'd eaten far too much lasagna the night before to compensate for breakfast that day.
All this was done in about 5 minutes, but because it had developed into a routine, it felt much faster. The only thing left to do before leaving the house was to shower and clean his teeth, which Andrew did at the same time to save water. He put on a nice shirt and jeans, which his wife had left on the dresser, and he was gone.
Andrew cycled to work. It was faster than walking and good exercise, as his office block sat at the top of the hill next to the veterinary centre. Passing groups of young undergraduates each day, Andrew thought to himself how much harder it was to cycle uphill than in his 20s. Part of him wanted to grab them by their sculpted shoulders to shape them to their temples ache like his did every single morning. But then he felt guilty and turned back to the road.
Special change, mate. Thank you.
Alright, Andy.
I'm doing fine, thanks.
How's it going?
Does it smell in here, or is it just me? Oh. And Nina's alright.
Nina was not alright.
Sorry, Andy. Smell?
Is the smell coming from here?
Yeah, I think that probably is the bloke outside, yeah.
Andrew realised that the smell was coming from the homeless man.
He had first noticed him there a couple of weeks ago.
The smell distracted him from his PowerPoint.
It is coming from that guy. First saw him there a couple of weeks ago. The smell is so unfair to the rest of the office.
Andrew realised he was coming across as neurotic, so he decided to ask his colleague a question.
So?
It was at this moment he realised he had no idea what his colleague's name was.
Morning, Paola.
Morning, Steve.
Steve! Oh, nothing.
I don't think you did see that homeless man there a few weeks ago, Andy.
Sorry?
Andy hated how Paola seemed to see or hear everything went on in the office so effortlessly. She skimmed gracefully over its surface like a water bug on a pond, while he, like a fat, ugly toad, wallowed in shit.
I said I don't think you did see that homeless man there a few weeks ago.
Why'd you say that?
Why? Because it was a different homeless man.
What?
The guy last week was black, and had this big, like, bushy beard, and a fucking, like, stars and stripes duvet, okay?
Andrew felt intensely emasculated.
Right, I see.
He decided that he would have an early lunch. In his bag was
1. Sushi. Fish is rich in omega acids, and rice is a slow burn source of energy.
2. A banana. We've been through this one.
3. An avocado sandwich. And inside.
Bread makes you fat, mate.
It does not!
Okay, you're the boss.
What makes you say that anyway?
It was in The Guardian.
Andrew was working on an intensely important reshuffle of the benefit system. His role in the team was to create a system that combined various welfare payments into a single bi-weekly sum. Partly this is to make it easier for the department to rein in costs by bringing the entire system under his purview. But the other benefit of a single bi-weekly sum...
I'm going to clock out. Night, guys.
Night.
Steve.
The other benefit of a single bi-weekly sum was that it would simplify the system for claimants while simultaneously making the distribution of money more similar to a paid salary. This would encourage claimants to spend...
Andy, are you alright?
I'm fine, Steve. Just fine.
It's Paola. By making a single bi-weekly sum more similar to a paid salary, the hope was that claimants would develop fiscal responsibility, and in doing so, who gives a shit? Andrew switched off his laptop. He wanted some space. He liked the dark of the office at night. It felt like a secret that only he was party to. Remnants of the daytime frozen in place. Time itself stopped. A tea stain mug, a tissue, a copy of the Metro. Andrew closed his eyes. Finally, he could breathe. And he did.
What the fuck was that? Oh, Jesus Christ!
Considered reporting the incident to the police, but decided against it almost immediately.
At first, he thought he felt pity for the homeless man. Ultimately, though, it would be a bureaucratic nightmare.
Then Andrew thought, the nerve of that guy, the nerve! He thinks he can just do whatever he wants.
And then he thought, God, I'm such a dick. That poor guy, he's all alone. He's lost his mind. He just needs some guidance, some help.
And then he thought, Jesus, that really just happened. I need to call that night. So he called at night.
As Andrew cycled back from work, he saw the homeless man. He was asleep on a wet public bench facing the road.
And all that he could think was, that poor bastard just needs someone to look after him.
Man's face, that he'd never been more at home. It was effortless.
Andrew wants to shout, what are you doing? You can't do that. You're homeless. You're going to catch pneumonia or something. But the homeless man didn't seem to care. His eyes were closed, guided by the hand of an unknown fate that he had completely accepted. Andrew felt a strange sense of jealousy, and he thought,
fucking bastard! My eyes are closed right now. I should be relaxed. Here I am, staring at your smug face.
But he didn't look smug, not at all. He looked serene without a care in the world. His torn jacket had given way to a beautiful suit. And his partner emerged from the darkness. Andrew realized that it was his wife that was too.
Mina! Mina? Where are you?
What is it?
Thank God.
I'm right here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
What is it?
I'm okay.
You don't need to say sorry. I just thought it was something bad.
It was bad. It was a nightmare. It was really nasty.
So it wasn't just the dancing one this time?
I mean, yes, it was the one with the dancing. But it's horrible dancing. It was different this time. It was a homeless man. He was doing the waltz. He has to have been there, I guess. I mean, you were there.
Andrew, I'm sorry. I have work in 3 hours.
Okay. It's okay.
You'll be all right.
Yeah, you're right. I'll be fine.
Andrew didn't get back to sleep that night. He hated how his thoughts kept chasing him, even when he turned off the lights. They just went on and on and on.
Andrew considered how his mood may be affected by his food intake. It was possible that he wasn't getting enough carbohydrates because of his insistence on maintaining a strict diet. In caveman times,
Andrew considered how, in contrast to his 20s, his diet seemed to have little or no impact on him. He looked tired and felt tired, and his bones seemed to ache, and his mind seemed to tire too fast, but his legs gave out very easily on his bike, even on a high gear. Could this get much worse?
You're talking to yourself again.
Andrew.
Andrew rolled out of bed an hour earlier than usual and slumped down the stairs. He had some leftover pasta from the fridge and a cup of coffee. He put on the same clothes as the day before and left the house quietly so as not to wake his wife. He had gone to find the homeless man.
Andrew could see the homeless man on the other side of the street, begging for change.
Sorry, mate, can you spell?
He looked helpless as well as homeless.
I'm clean, I just need a place to stay.
And the smell is still disgusting.
Excuse
don't
me.
Touch me.
But it was hard to know what to do.
Do you have some spare change?
The man would probably spend his cash on drink.
Paola!
Hello, Mickey.
Or drugs.
I've got something for you.
As it happens, I've got something for you too.
You really shouldn't, you know, give him money, that is. Excuse me?
It's a book.
It's a book? Well, now I feel bad, I'm going to print something bigger.
Nah, it's a small book, but you like it, it's your sort of thing. It's these two lost souls, and, they find it.
Oh, God. This is a bit like when you got me Romeo and Juliet.
Nah, this is one day. It's a young girl and a young man, and they fall in love, and they want to fix the world, but instead of one day, it's actually 20 years. It's clever.
Brilliant. No, it's like when you got me the Da Vinci Code.
I actually love the Da Vinci Code, really.
If I say what I think, will you tell?
Yeah, I promise.
Well, I don't not like the Da Vinci Code.
The secret's safe in me.
Want to see what I got?
What is it?
You want a hot water bottle, Mickey.
Exactly.
But you have a kettle. Look, what these do is you charge them up and they go hot for about 20 minutes and then I'll recharge them when they run out.
Cheers, mate. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
I've got a presentation at work, but I'm off, okay?
Right, well, I'll see you soon, and don't knock the book until you've read it.
Hello, sir. I have got you this banana.
Oh, I see.
Bananas are very good for you.
Oh, they are.
I've got you other things too. Antibacterial hand wash, in case your hands get dirty. And deodorant. I'll be back with more next week. My name's Andrew, by the way.
Thank you, sir. Have a good day.
No. You had a good day.
Andrew walked off feeling proud of himself at finding his wedding ring. He had lost quite a lot of weight from his diet over the past month, and the ring, now one size too big, slipped off his finger constantly.
He rationalised this by saying, it's probably a good thing. Reminds him of Nina. And he sent her a text saying, just thinking of you, love, which made him very pleased he could be so thoughtful.
And she said,
scene, 8:45 a.m.
Hang on. She didn't say anything.
What? Andrew was forgetting something. Something very important.
But what very important thing was Andrew forgetting?
Maybe it was to do with Nina.
Or the homeless man.
Or Steve.
Or Paola.
Oh.
Oh, fuck! The benefits project!
It's lovely to see you. God, it's been ages, hasn't it?
Andrew was shitting his pants. Not literally, but almost.
Do we have an intern? Tim, could you get us a cup of tea? Cheers, Tim.
Andy hadn't gone over the document the day before, but he'd sent it off, so it'd be fine. Everything would be fine.
Crikey, am I tired. I had to catch a train at 7:20 for this meeting, so it better be good. No pressure though, guys. Oh, fab. Cheers, Tim. Right.
Right.
Shit.
Fuck.
Bollocks.
Sorry, Andy, what was that?
Oh, I said fuck. Come on! Because I'm excited for this one.
Great, that's good enthusiasm. Should we start with you then? Yeah. Basically, we've all looked at your proposals. We really like them. There's some good detail in there. So we showed them to the Undersecretary. And obviously, the Undersecretary had to report about them to the Minister. And he said, it's probably not the right time, given everything that's going on right now. So we'll shelve it. Good report, though.
Sorry, what's going on right now?
Well, you know, the Defence Secretary touched a woman's elbow at a dinner party, among other things.
Hang on a minute. Just me. This is an intensely important reshuffle of the benefit system!
Well, Andy, it was an intensely important woman's elbow.
And just like that, they moved on.
No fuss. And they all just kept saying words, but the words didn't mean anything at all.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah. Blah. Blah!
Andy expected someone to stand up and say, "Excuse me, John, you London-based fuck. We know you're looking the single most important reshuffle of the benefit system since the invention of the benefit system."
No, he didn't.
What?
Andrew didn't expect that because the report was shit. He expected John to take out a copy of the report, point at it, and piss himself laughing.
It wasn't Andy's fault. It was the concept that's flawed. Everyone else in this office is full of shit, especially Paola. Oh, where's your report, Paola? Oh yeah, that's right, you didn't do one, because you're too busy wanking off Steve in the stationery cupboard. Paola was most definitely not too busy wanking off Steve in the stationery cupboard. And if Andy hadn't been so busy projecting his problem onto everyone else for the past 4 years, maybe they'd have been promoted.
There's nothing wrong with not getting promoted.
Not if you're a fucking idiot.
I'm not a fucking idiot. It's just not lost.
Bed, isn't it?
Not today.
Well, I'm sorry, I thought you had Thursdays off. Are you wondering why I've come home?
You could say that.
Well, I knew I'd forgotten something this morning on my way to work.
Forgotten something?
Yes, none of remembered what it was. Today was the day of the meeting for my benefits project.
Today?
Yeah, and I went. I know it's the strangest thing, but I just now walked straight out of it.
Why?
They completely dumped my report. I thought, fuck them, Andrew. You look after yourself. But it's good to be with you too, honey.
Andrew, do you know what day it is?
Well, it's the 22nd of March.
Yeah. What day is that?
Friday?
That's not what I meant.
Nina, I've got no idea what you're getting at.
Cheer up, mate.
Are you super rough?
Yeah, are you?
Well, definitely. You probably deserve a drink.
Sit here, you bastard.
Oh, I thought you'd never ask. Fire story. I'm such a fucking.
Are you right?
I'm fine, pal. I'm just fine.
My name's Steve. I'm Steve.
Oh my God, Andy, are you okay?
I drink.
No, are you drunk?
I never guess what I fucking did.
Did Mickey tell you?
That's not Mickey.
Work.
So past 1 in the afternoon, mate.
Not you again.
Nothing. Doesn't matter. It's all fucked anyway.
I heard that a lot while you were asleep. Anyway, what time have you got to go to work?
Well, about 5 hours ago, I suppose.
Shit, you need to take more time out, mate. You drank at least a bottle of vodka.
I should go into work. Have you not got anything better to do than sit here watching over me?
Sure I do. But you need help.
What? Oh, God, my head.
What help? Mate, I don't know if anyone's ever told you this, but I think you have a little problem with nerves.
The nerves?
Yeah, nerves, yeah. You look like you can hear all your thoughts talking to you all the time.
That's funny.
I say that because my husband used to be exactly the same way. He was really full on. But he was lovely. He did flowers mostly.
Oh, I didn't realise you were gay.
I'm a woman, Andrew. Yeah. He used to do like summer exhibitions in different villages and towns. They'd have proper prizes and panels and judges. And so he wanted to do well. You could literally watch him all afternoon, straightening out little violets. And he'd take his gloves off and straighten out the petals on the daisies.
All I do is move numbers around.
The way he did it, really. You know, like in Alice in Wonderland, when the playing cards paint the white roses red? I wouldn't have put it past him.
What happened?
Well, towns don't have any money for that kind of thing anymore. And then there was this reshuffle of the benefit system. What?
Nothing.
Yeah, and when he thought of things, he'd look up to the left. You do exactly the same thing, actually.
Anyway, what about you?
Oh, I was in 0 hours at Summerfield, and my supervisor hated me, so that wasn't going to last. And shit happens.
What do you do these days?
I read. I'd like to write.
It's not bad. I haven't read anything. I haven't read anything. Not in ages. I'm just out of the time. Well, maybe I will now I'm getting fired and divorced.
Oh, see, this is what I mean. One tiny thing happens and you think the sky's going to fall down on you.
Go on.
Well, what happened?
I walked out of a meeting I've been preparing for months. My wife, she's in a terrible way. Yesterday was supposed to be a big day for her. I forgot everything. I'm a bastard.
Sounds like a pretty good day to me.
In what way?
Well, you wake up and you're home with your wife, and you go to a job, you've got a nice job, and that's a nice office too. And then when you skip work, they don't even fire you. They don't sack you, they just say, well, they don't even say, where is he? What is he doing? They just want to know you're okay.
It wasn't quite like that. Nina's, she's not in her right mind. To work, they'd probably fire me now.
Oh, don't be stupid. Paola came to see me this morning. She was almost crying. And Steve as well. They were worried sick about you, and your wife will be too. They thought you were dead. They thought you were going to die, and yet here you are. You're not dead. Are you?
Andrew,
I feel fine.
No, you're not.
I didn't say that.
Oh, sorry. My mistake. What did you say?
Andrew felt very alone and afraid.
I guess I feel fine.
I know I should feel alone, afraid, but I just feel fine.
Andy had hit rock bottom.
I mean, I've hit rock bottom and it's fine.
That's a bit like Taoism. Have you read the Laozi?
She was very pretentious for someone who slept on the street.
I haven't. What's it about?
Well, I wish I could write something like this.
She withdrew a tattered book, which she probably couldn't even read.
Mastering the self requires strength.
She sounded like an edgy 15-year-old literature student.
He who knows he has enough is rich.
Her clothes were ugly and covered in shit.
Perseverance is a sign of willpower.
Fucking bitch!
He who stays where he is endures. To die but not to perish is to be eternally present.
And he couldn't stand the bullshit coming out of her mouth.
Nina's dad used to say things like that.
Oh, come on!
Is that your wife?
Yeah. Her dad was a priest.
Do you mind?
He knew all these lofty quotes, and he'd say one every time he left the room.
Nina, she was studying philosophy at the time.
She was quite anti-religious. She used to say it'd been proven wrong when the ancient Greeks were still around. But he knew all these Greek quotes too, so he'd call her out.
How did you two meet?
At his church, actually. My mum used to make me go right to the front. I was the only person under 40 who sat in the front row. Except her, actually.
What happened?
Well, my mum always made God sound like quite a scary guy.
Don't worry about it, mate. She probably just read the first part. The Bible gets more predictable as it goes on, to be fair.
I don't blame her. I never read it. I'm not sure she did either, to be honest. But Nina's dad, he felt sorry for me, I think. He was always saying, God forgives. And he used to get Nina to check on me, see if I was all right. Well, I suppose we liked talking to each other quite a lot more than he thought in the end.
And then what happened?
Nothing. He died. But shit happens, I suppose. We're supposed to scatter his ashes on his birthday.
When's that?
22nd of March.
That's quite soon.
It was yesterday.
Oh, I'm sorry, Andrew.
Where's Louis?
Andrew decided to go to work and apologise to his boss.
I can't go home. Oh, I don't know what to say.
Nina would never take him back.
Well, she loves you, doesn't she?
Andrew decided to go to work to try and save his job.
Well, that's the focus then, not your mistake or your job.
Andrew started walking to the office.
Look,
if she doesn't forgive you, at least forgive yourself.
Andrew started walking to the office!
Andrew and Nina went back to the village. They found a stream near the parish church. They had a ceramic pot in their bag, which Nina unscrewed carefully, taking care not to spill the contents. Each of them took a handful, the ash spilling from the sides of their hands. Side by side, they scattered it onto the water. Mickey never saw Andrew again. Paola said he'd left the office, but she'd hoped that he'd... She didn't know if his problems had followed him or not, or if he found new ones, or if his old ones had been solved. But she'd hoped he'd be in a better place now. Dedicated to Louis. Paola, I've got a new book for you.